kid. We're gonna make this historic. We're gonna make this historic, ladies and gentlemen. If you're proud to be a part of the Clapton family, just make a little noise. Just give me a whoop. Yeah. And they are looking wonderful this evening. They ain't gonna say that. They are still looking at them. Y'all look absolutely wonderful. We have the governor's wife, the building where she's the governor's wife. The governor's wife, she's in the building, the governor's wife. Some very, very important news that you guys should please listen to. This is very, very important news from the top. The First Lady says that you guys can now cut your pay.
Thank you so much for continuing to support this event. This is And a lot of you have been out here with us basically the entire time. And we just want to say thank you, thank you, thank you. Without you, we couldn't do what we do for these students. We, right now, would like to just give a hand to our wonderful First Lady, because without her, we would not be having this celebration. Thank you, Mrs. Tisdale. And we want to thank all of those visionaries who came before, who came up with the idea of beginning a First Lady's hats and gloves tea, and now blossom into something that we look forward to. Well, tomorrow begins spring, but every spring in Orangeburg, this is our event. At this time, I would like to recognize the members of the First Lady's Hats and Gloves Scholarship Tea Committee, those of us who have worked diligently so that this event could take place. At this time, I would like to ask the committee members if they would please join Mr. Burgess and myself up on the stage. Our committee members are Ms. Tammy McCartney, co-chair, Dr. Peggy Stevenson-Rabbit, co-chair, Reverend Minnie Cutler-Anderson, Mr. Marcus Burgess, Ms. Jordan Cutler, one of our students, Ms. Shantika O'Tisdale, and Dr. Burley Tisdale. These are our committee members. We ask everyone to please join us here as we prepare to present our chair.
Here we go. One more.
Like jewels in a crown. Vanilla, cinnamon, and dark chocolate brown. Now picture yourself in the midst of this glory as I describe the sisters who are part of this story. Some had elegant hats on their heads. With sparkling eyes and shiny lips, they moved through the room, swaying their hips. Beautiful sisters all, who were loving and caring. You see, it's not about how these sisters appeared. Their beauty was in the values they revealed. They were smart, articulate, and well-read, with all kinds of Black history stored in their heads. Of your table friends. This marks the 13th year of our community gathering, and believe it or not, we have grown from about 30 women at our very beginning to now well over 550 tonight. Under the visionary leadership of Henry Nehemiah Tisdale, the 8th president of CAC. Let me first acknowledge a few guests present with us this evening. Of course, your president and friend and my husband, Henry Nehemiah Tisdale. Of course, my family is here this evening. Can't let the evening go by without acknowledging my special friend, Emma Harmon, and her guest. My church will be here. Where are you guys? There they are. No matter how long it takes me to get to church, it's good. The First Lady of the state of South Carolina, Mrs. Peggy McMaster. McMaster, where are you? And her person accompanying her is Nancy Buck. Tonight is my final year serving as hostess for this yearly event. It is a bittersweet special event during the many years of its existence. I pray that this flagship event will continue on in the years to come. I promise you, I will not miss people. I'll see you around often. As most of you know, I took a bad tumble in November and fractured my hip. Well, while on that road to recovery, I have since been diagnosed with breast cancer. I have been in treatment for a time, and trust me when I say that I am progressing well. In the months to come, I plan to, in the words of Jill Scott, live my life like it's golden. I plan, my friends, to continue in my healing, and I encourage you to join me and become an advocate, a champion for women's and children's rights everywhere. I want to acknowledge and thank the women of the Mad Hatter's Club, my posse, for working so diligently to make this event happen again this year. Let us now call to the front our honorees of the evening, our bold, fearless, and visionary champions,
some of you might recall, and I can honestly say what you're doing really makes a difference. But I cannot leave the stage without giving due honor to Alice Carson Tisdale.
Thank you for all that you have done to inspire not just us, but a whole community, a whole state, a whole nation. Thank you so much, the First Lady's Hats and Gloves Scholarship Team. We also have a small gift for you.
These colors are beautiful.
Part of our chapter and supporting all of our events, we dearly thank you.